up being the worst possible fucking situation. We're looking for a room in Caroline. Our last option is an economy triple. I'm 5 minutes away from putting the appointment in. Oh my god. Please. Acceptance, yeah. That's my stage. First it was denial. Now it's acceptance. After 2:15 will be grief. So if you don't know what's happening here, UMass assigns housing based off your priority number, and if you're a freshman going into sophomore year, you have a pretty low priority number. And our appointment was at 2:15, and I had to click my room just in time, and if we didn't get this room, which was an Econ Triple, which is a lower priced but smaller apartment with 3 roommates for a 2-person room, then we would have gotten no housing. So as a freshman, you just have to endure it and try your best. So we were on the 6th floor, room 610, and the thing about room 610 is that you have to go to the 7th or the 5th floor and then walk a flight of stairs down for some reason. Not a big deal, just kind of weird, and I was like disoriented the first day moving in, so just know that. So yeah, this is going down the stairs, and then our room is pretty much directly as soon as you walk into the hallway. So this is the laundry machine. There's one washer, one dryer, and if you get the app SpeedQueen, which I highly recommend, it can tell you on your phone which ones are open. So it's actually not that bad when you have the app. So this is the main entrance. Don't ask. So when you first walk in, this is the view. So you see one room here. I'm not gonna pan because I don't know if my roommate wants me to, but you have this end and then you see straight to, that's like my stuff over there. And then, yeah, so pan to left, we have 2 closets. My roommate Caroline had the good idea of putting like a barrier. Okay, so I just did 0.5. So I tried to like color coordinate my closet. Kind of worked, but I would say the space is pretty actually like really good for an Econ Triple. Like I can fit full-on coats. I have my ski jacket in here. And then up there you have a huge space for all this other stuff. So usually I put my shower stuff, my laundry, and like hats and scarves and gloves and stuff. And then down here you have a lot of I'm a bad example because I have my ski stuff here, so of course it's gonna be crowded, but I have like, you know, I only brought like 2 shoes with me, so it works well for me. And then my laundry basket is up there. And then stuff is bursting out of my drawers, as you can see, but 3 jars. Pretty spacious. Again, I'm a bad example because I climb, so I have like a million freaking things crammed into jars. And there's even space like right up here for more stuff that I don't utilize as much. But yeah, so a lot of space. And then I put this here to hang my towels. On the door, they have these things for towels, but I don't know. That's kind of like our shared door, so no one really puts stuff there. But like, I just put my towels there and it works pretty well. Only thing is this freaking bar. Like, sometimes I just accidentally, like, shove off, taking out my stuff, and it falls, like, on your head. So watch out for that. Very hazardous, very dangerous. So then, my roommate's closet, whatever. So let's go back to 1. So this mirror comes with the room. Very nice, very big. My roommate and I do, like, use it at the same time, so it's kind of funny. This is my side of the room, so just take it in, take it in. I'm actually gonna put more light here, just to show you guys the natural light. So 610 in Coolidge is actually perfect for natural light because it's not hot in the warmer months because we're not really facing directly the sun. And you still get a good view of the mountains. So as you can see, this is our view. You get a good view of Hamp, the courtyard, and the other building. I don't even know what building that is. Whatever. So yeah, it's a pretty nice view. Like, I actually really love the mountains, especially during sunset. You get really pretty views here. And the lighting is great. There's also a window right here, but we'll go into that in a second. So yeah, I luckily got the window side of the room because I took the bunk bed, which I didn't even make, so sorry about that. So I figured like I would get this half of the room. So let's zoom in to these like little portions here. So let's start over here. So here is a perfect space to keep a fridge and a microwave. This worked perfectly for us. We didn't dust it the entire year. That's why it looks like that. But these are like our shared items. So like Ziploc bags, whatever, like candy we want to share. This is our wonderful calendar that keeps us sane because we get to check off the days. Yes. And then I put this here to hang my cute little, like I have this like Hello Kitty, like I don't know, a purse and my room keys. So I'm kind of like taking over this space slowly. I realize that it's kind of my fault, but zooming in, this I really recommend. I put this here to hold necklaces, these two things. So super convenient. Again, never dusted this the entire year. So, but yeah, all the essentials. We have our shot glasses. This one, my lovely roommate Caroline got of me. Just don't even ask what that picture is about, but all of our shot glasses here. This one Marco got for me. Perfume. The good thing about, the fun thing about college and having like condensed space is like utilizing one thing for more. So like this is a really shitty and like kind of pathetic example, but I use my perfume to also hold my hair ties, which I only have two of that I've been reusing the entire year. So in case you needed a place to put your hair ties, just put it on a freaking perfume thing. Also use mugs for more than one thing. This used to have stuff in it, but you know, use mugs for like pens and then take it out to use it for drinks. This is like our grab and go like fork container. It's like burst out of its seams, just like pens. This favorite part of my entire room, I got this from Box Lunch, little fake Hello Kitty plant, love it. Yeah, over here, Grace got this for me, and this one is so cute, but just little things here. But I recommend for earrings, I just have them in this little storage cabinet, and I just don't take them out. I just have them in there and then take them whenever, because I feel like it's so easy to lose earrings in a room like this and never find them again. So I recommend just keeping them in like one little container like that instead of making it like fancy, like, oh, like a corkboard, Pinterest DIY, like it's better to not. This is from Amazon, little Sailor Moon case. Little boxes are really, really helpful because they separate all your shit in a cute way because you don't have that much space. Ignore all the hair in my literal hairbrush. So in here I keep hairbrush, just don't even ask, Tide stick, get this. I keep like the lesser things, film, what else? Oh, gonna need this most of the time. Eyeshadow, stuff like that. So cute little storage bins are really great for separating stuff. This cute little tapestry I got because I thought that it would make the room look bigger, which I kind of do love it actually. Another storage bin, claw clips, mini brands, flash drives, like just put everything in there. Don't even think about it. Mirror / scrunchie holder. That's a hack, I guess. I have little cute things here, like my little vegetable man with my mini brands. Thank you, Grace. This stuff is always cute. I got this from Urban. Oh, hello, surprise jump scare in the mirror. Yeah. This perfume was $6 from Miniso. I really recommend. Always, just like your elementary school teacher told you in elementary school, bring tissues to school. Because, Lord, the first time you get sick, you will be, like, dying and don't want to leave and you won't have tissues. So, yeah, this is my camera corner. So I just have this hefty guy, little guy. And a corkboard is always the cutest. I took all my pictures off because I'm going home soon. But I have a little bit, as you can see, like some little memories. It just like really brightens the room. Here. Oh my God, okay. So this is Mango. This is our fish. She's still alive if you remember her from our video a long time ago. She's still alive. Hey. I don't want any vets in the comments. She's perfectly fine. Like, yes, there is no filter in the tank anymore because we forgot to get padding. But the tank is actually cleaner than it was with the filter. So I think it's all a scam. And we actually feed her premium bloodworms. And yeah, so don't worry, she's fine. Like, she's great. She's still alive, so she will be coming home with me. So there's three drawers here, pretty spacious actually. For like an Econ Triple, there's actually a lot of space in here, so don't be like distraught when you get an Econ Triple. Ignore the condoms, but yeah, literally just all candy, condoms, Dayquil, like this shit is whatever. I'm not gonna show you guys what's in there. Yeah, a lot of space to put stuff. And here, there's even another pullout to put more stuff. So I keep like my computer in here and all that. It's just great. A lot of space. This is my desktop computer. It's an iMac. It's so freaking useful. And it's pretty. I know I'm not gonna, no one's gonna be like, oh my god, there's so many fingerprints on there though. Sheesh. But yeah, this behind my iMac, there's a lot of space for books. It extends like the entire way across. So I have like tons of books there in size. And this is like my water bottle, like trash corner. So I have like my water bottle, tumbler, my wife. Just some things like this I haven't even thrown out. This is from today, so don't worry. But yeah, lots of space to leave trash, luckily. And my little Hello Kitty. With even space back there to put more stuff. So this is moldy though, I should throw this out. But my trash is overflowing. So I'm gonna show you guys how to throw out the trash while also throwing out my own trash. But I usually put like my tote bags like to the side. And I even have space for a New Hampshire shaped rock. So it's kind of clutch. Like the space in here is actually great. Yeah. One thing that's annoying is the wires kind of get tangled, but it's like people are dying, so it's not really a huge complaint of mine. But I haven't made my bed, but that's the bunk. So this is the, okay, I won't show my roommate's side because, oh, whatever, we'll fix it. So this is what the bunk looks like, and it's not made, but there's some room up there to like put some pictures. I actually have a lot of stuffed animals in there, so I'll clean it and then do another take. But back here, we have this IKEA, like, storage bin. And it actually holds so much stuff. So here we have, like, fish stuff and conglomerate trash, feminine hygiene products. Fits all in there. Back there, I even have my skateboard and my skis. So basically, I've taken over this entire room. But a lot of space. And then here's another window that you can open in, obviously. But yeah, so that's kind of the room. I'll show you guys my roommate's side when they come back. So now I will show you the study room, laundry room, bathroom, entrance, I guess. So yeah. So this is the bathroom. Pretty standard bathroom. Had a few nights here, literally. It will be your comfort zone. It will be your solace. It will be really your dream. This is the shower. You have the Southwest trough, very synonymous with Southwest. All the water just kind of runs down into a communal trough. It's pretty sexy. Lots of stalls. All of them are usually always messed up somehow with some ungodly like thing. I don't know. Then you walk to the other side. There's actually, it's a huge circle, so you can walk around either side. But the recycling and trash room. Walk in. There's a sink, so it's kind of convenient to wash out your recycling before you put it in the recycling bin. And there's the area for all the cardboard. And it's a little bit confusing at first, kind of like a weird circular maze, I don't know. The architecture is kind of cool, but like, kind of random. This is the study room. Connects the other side of the hallway as well. A lot of space, but it's kind of awkward when you come in and there's like one person sitting there and you're like, do I stay? Do I go? You know what I mean? But it's usually pretty empty. There's a study room on every floor, and there's 21 floors, so you're bound to find privacy. And this is the view, which is also really nice, actually. And mostly direct sunlight.
So I think that's it. Now back to more room stuff.
Okay, this is my bed made. All my little plushies and my little photos. And this is like, so from up here. So from up in the palace, well, there's this, which I've not dusted and I might be breathing in. God knows, because look at that. Speaking of which, I also have the fire alarm right there. It actually went off one time and it was very, very loud. But I also have space for a reading lamp. But yeah, this is the view. It like feels pretty high, like I won't lie. So.
Anyway, that's all for the room tour. I actually moved out before I could film like the entrance, but that's kind of self-explanatory and you don't really need to know that. But here are must-haves for moving in. Not must-have, my must-haves, but they will definitely help you. And there is hope if you're on Econ Triple. I love my roommates, so I don't have a problem. I just want more privacy. If you dislike your roommates or you have like some other problems, like I did, because I'm weird, literally it's not that hard to transfer to a north apartment your sophomore year, the second semester, because all of the people who are in north usually go there because it's easy to go abroad that spring semester. So the only reason that I got into north this semester was because someone transferred out just for abroad. So you can easily get to north probably if you want. So don't feel like, oh, I can't get, you know, I'm stuck here or whatever. And then the day, the Econ Triple is really fun, especially if you love your roommates like I did. And it's also like in the heart of Southwest. And if you want the Southwest experience, it is the place to be. It's right next to Hamp, right next to Burke, right next to everything. Well, everything except for your classes, but all the nightlife and stuff is pretty much there. I will say Central was a bit closer to the frats. Depends which ones you go to. If you don't go to frats, don't worry about it. But yeah, that is all. I hope that helped you. And look forward to a North apartment tour. So,